So what's going on, guys? It's JM at Speedboxing. Make sure you subscribe to my channel before you click onto any of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. It really helps me out. If you guys could drop me a sub or two on my channel, it is appreciated. So after his 11th round knockout victory over Vladimir Klitschko last night, IBF and WBA heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua says that he'll be out of the ring now until October and that he'll only probably fight two fights a year for the rest of his career, however long that lasts. And I see a few people complaining about this, saying we should be fighting more than that. But this isn't unusual. When a fighter gets to a certain level when it comes to pay-per-view attraction, then you only see him for twice a year, sometimes even once a year. In the 80s, it was a little bit different. In the late 70s and 80s, when guys like Sugar Ray Leonard and Tommy Hearns were around, these guys tend to fight two, three times a year. Well, mostly three times a year, but things changed. And when guys become an attraction, they pick out two dates a year, like Mayweather, it was May and September. Canelo's doing the same thing now, he's fighting in May and September. Oscar De La Hoya only fought twice a year after he lost to Felix Trinidad. So this isn't really unusual. When a fighter becomes such a draw in boxing, the fights usually get a lot of hype and build up, and it takes a few months to do that, and there's only 12 months in a year at the end of the day. And plus, fighters need breaks in between and stuff like that, because fighters are only human, they need to have time off just like everybody else. So yeah, it'd be interesting to see who Anthony Joshua fights in October, because he's got two mandatories. He's got Kubrat Pulev, he's number one mandatory for the IBF, and Luis Ortiz, he's number one with the WBA. And I can see the IBF stripping Joshua if he don't fight Pulev next. But a lot of people, in my opinion, wouldn't want him to fight Kubrat Pulev, because Pulev is a decent opponent, but he's not the best opponent, especially with Anthony Joshua coming on a high wave since his victory over Vladimir Klitschko. People are saying, oh, he's going to fight next Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury. So if you fought Kubrat Pulev, I can see a few people complaining. Well, I can see a lot of people complaining. But I see the IBF stripping him if he doesn't take that fight. Or he could just not fight none of his mandatories and fight Deontay Wilder and try and pay Luis Ortiz step-aside money and get stripped of his IBF or vacate it. But then Luis Ortiz is saying he's not going to take step-aside money. He wants his shot now. Because Luis Ortiz is an aging fighter. He is 38 years old. Well, that's what he says. I think he's in his mid-40s, but yeah, I've said that before, but I see him wanting his shot now, because time's ticking for Luis Ortiz, and he just wants his crack at the heavyweight title. So it'd be interesting if Anthony Joshua takes that fight. That would definitely tell me a lot about his character if he faces the boogeyman of the division, who all the other heavyweight champions don't want to seem to know. Deontay Wilder doesn't want to fight him. Joseph Parker hasn't mentioned him. I'll be interested if Anthony Joshua actually gets in the ring with Luis Ortiz, because I think Luis Ortiz wants the Anthony Joshua fight. He's mentioned Anthony Joshua before, saying he'd like to fight him, and he thinks he could beat him in spectacular fashion. So yeah, Anthony Joshua saying he's only going to fight twice a year, and people are complaining, but this is nothing new. Fighters have done this for a long time, especially when they're high level pay-per-view fighters. You only see him on select dates, and you're not expecting him to fight five times a year or four times a year. It just don't happen. People have got to be realistic sometimes. So yeah, comment below your opinion.